Yes. So that is our question number 6. Question number 6 tumba important to mark maadkoli. Okay? Right. Now let us proceed further. Question number 7. The question asked here is, which reagent is used in Rosenmann reduction? We can discuss Rosenmann reduction. I told you it's very important name reaction. What is the reagent used here? The reagent used here is hydrogen gas in presence of palladium, which is poisoned with quinoline, supported over barium sulfate. So option D is the answer straight away. This is Rosenmann reduction in general. So what happens during Rosenmann reduction? An acid chloride is taken, made to react with hydrogen gas in presence of palladium, which is poisoned, reduces efficiency. Acid chloride gets converted to aldehyde, RCHO. And yes, of course, what gets liberated is HCl. The byproduct is HCl. Yes, this is Rosenmann reduction. Easy question, easy question. Question number 8. Hope you have recognized this question or the reaction here. Check mark. There is a sequence of reaction given. There is a reaction sequence given. This is the reaction sequence. Now in this we have to find out what is final product B. Final product B, which means you should know what A is. So in entrance exams like CET and NEET, you will come across such sequence of reactions based questions. Okay, a series of reactions given, you have to find out the final product B or whatever is the final product. Okay, yes, let's write out. First, CH3CH2Br, CH3CH2Br, made to react with KCN. Please recollect our reactions from haloalkanes. An alkyl halide, when made to react with potassium cyanide, gives you the corresponding nitrile. Br, check this, bromine atom gets replaced by cyanide nucleophile in a simple nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is a simple nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution, substitution reaction. Yes. So what is the product we get? Check out the product. The product we get is CH3 CH2 CN. This is propane nitrile. Propane nitrile is the product. Now this is actually our product A. So we have found out what is A. Now A is treated with this whole set of reagents. Check out. Put this whole set of reagents. What are the reagents? Stannous chloride. One. Stannous chloride. In presence of or in suspension of ether, saturated with HCl. Okay, amine. Second step in Antare. Second step only, you are carrying out hydrolysis. So what does this remind us of? Which reaction? This reminds us of this very important reaction in nitrile called Stefan reduction. This is what is your Stefan reduction. Yes. So what happens in Stefan reduction? Nitrile part gets converted to aldehyde. Nitrile part gets converted to aldehyde. CH3. CH2 is hage irutte enu change illa, but observe maadi, the CN group nitrile which I have circled is changed into CHO aldehyde. So this is your final product B. Okay, which option matches our solution here? Option A is an amine, ruled out. Option B is an amide. This is an amine. This is an amide, ruled out. Okay. Option C is an aldehyde. Yes, that's our correct answer. Option C is our correct answer. Okay. Option D is actually a carboxylic acid. So, also ruled out. That's not what we get. Carboxylic acid barala the reaction only. Carboxylic acid. But not the correct answer. Okay. Fine. That was question number 8. Question number 8. Now we proceed further. Okay. Question number 9. toluene. Toluene on oxidation. Toluene on oxidation using CrO3 and HCrO3 in presence of acetic anhydride, followed by treatment with sodium aqueous sodium hydroxide gives. Okay, we'll check this out. This reaction is where you take toluene. Toluene. Made to react with 1 CrO3 and acetic anhydride CH3CO2O. This is acetic anhydride. Okay, followed by treatment with aqueous enol. Hydrolysis agarathosha. OH minus water. Hydrolysis. Alkaline hydrolysis. So, what's the product we get? CH3 group. The CH3 group is directly converted to the aldehyde group, CHO group. So, see the product we get. We get benzaldehyde. CH3 becomes CHO. Benzaldehyde is the product. Yes. So, what is the correct answer? Option A. Option A itself is the correct answer. Good. Very good. That was question number 9. Now, coming to question number 10. 10th question. We have acetyl chloride and acid chloride reacting with dimethyl cadmium. This is dialkyl cadmium. Check this. Dialkyl cadmium. Okay, what happens when acid chlorides react with dialkyl cadmium? This is the general reaction. Acid chloride R prime COCl. Okay, made to react with dimethyl cadmium or just alkyl cadmium, dialkyl cadmium R2CD. Now check out the product again. The R group, okay, this R group attacks this sending out chloride. So you should end up getting R prime, C double bond O. Now carbonyl group is not attached to chlorine, it is attached to R group. This is what gives you ketone as the product. Ketone as the product. Plus, of course, what is the byproduct we get? We get cadmium chloride. And from 1 mole of alkyl cadmium, you actually get 2 moles of ketone. 2 moles of ketone. And that requires 2 moles of acid chloride. Yes. So, this is a general reaction. But what is the given acid chloride? Acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride, as we know, very simple. In place of R, you write CH3. CH3COCl is acetyl chloride. Okay? Made to react with what? Methyl cadmium, dimethyl cadmium. CH3 twice CD. Easy. Adhetra, just like the general reaction. Okay? Let me mark it now. See? The CH3 part attacks the carbon group and this moves out. So, what is the final product we get? What is the final product you get? You get CH3CO. This CO is again attached to one more CH3 coming from dimethyl cadmium plus cadmium chloride. Yeah. What is this compound? Acetone. Acetone is the product. Now, my apologies here. Both options mean the same. Acetone andru vande, propanone andru vande. So A, B, erdu same anbidide, okay? So we'll correct it. We'll correct it. Erdu option. Yes. Take a couple of seconds, write it down. Bega bakodi before I move on to the next slide. Yes. Okay. Let's proceed further. Let's see if we still have a few more questions or are we going for methods, chemical properties? Yes, that's about questions on methods of preparations of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, that is how we prepare aldehydes and ketones. Now, let's take up physical properties and chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones, starting with physical properties. What are the points you need to focus on? Okay, remember the boiling points of aldehydes and ketones would be higher than corresponding hydrocarbons. and for this the condition is molecular mass must be comparable. That goes without saying. Then boiling points of aldehydes and ketones lower than, this is important, lower than that of alcohols. Yeah, so what's the reason? The reason is very simple. Aldehydes and ketones do not have hydrogen bonding. Absence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding in aldehydes and ketones. In aldehydes and ketones. Okay? Yes. Now, next comes to issue is solubility. Though aldehydes and ketones cannot form hydrogen bonds with themselves, they form strong hydrogen bonds with water. Hence, they are soluble. At least the lower members are highly soluble in water. Okay? So, this is important. That's about physical properties. Now, let's see if there is any question on that, or we said we move on to chemical properties. Yes. Chemical properties. The chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones is decided or determined by this very important group. What do you call this group? This group is called the carbonyl group. Carbonyl group. Very important. Okay? Yes. Now, what kind of reaction will aldehydes and ketones undergo? Please check this. Oxygen being more electronegative. Oxygen jaasti electronegative aagirodrinda, it will pull electrons towards itself, thereby acquiring a partial negative charge, and carbon acquires a partial positive charge. Because carbon acquires a partial positive charge, it gets attracted or it gets attacked by a nucleophile. Nucleophile makes an attack on the carbonyl carbon, okay, thus resulting in this product. Since a nucleophile is added to the substrate, you call such reactions nucleophilic addition. Typical reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Nucleophilic addition reactions usually shown by aldehydes and ketones. Shown by aldehydes and ketones. Yes? Okay. Now, in this category of reactions, what is the order of reactivity of aldehydes and ketones? Aldehydes just reactive agiruttha, ketones just reactive agiruttha. Okay? Let's settle that out. This is the reactivity order. Mark it, important. Reactivity order of aldehydes and ketones. What is it? Aldehydes are more reactive than ketones. Very important. Aldehydes more reactive than ketones. First part. Always aldehydes more reactive than ketones. Then between aliphatic and aromatic versions, aliphatic aldehydes ketones. Aliphatic aldehydes bar ketones more reactive than their aromatic counterparts. Aromatic compounds. So, tumba important entrance exam ge, aldehydes are more reactive than ketones, then aliphatic aldehydes and ketones are more reactive than the aromatic ones. Yes. Please keep writing it down. Okay, next we'll see some examples. Examples of nucleophilic addition. Examples of nucleophilic addition reactions. Yes. So first one is addition of HCl, where cyanide has a nucleophile. This is the nucleophile, and the corresponding product is cyanohydrin. Okay. Cyanohydrin, where you have both cyanide and OH group. Next is addition of sodium bisulfite. Here the nucleophile is HSO3- is a nucleophile. So that adds on, first gives you this compound intermediate which undergoes proton transfer, and you get a bisulfite addition product. Bisulfite addition compound, yes. Okay. This reaction is used in purification of aldehydes and ketones. Used to purify aldehydes and ketones. Yes. Next, addition of alcohols. Okay, this is interesting. An aldehyde will react with one equivalent of an alcohol to give what is called as a hemiacetal. Hemiacetal. And it reacts with the second equivalent of alcohol to give a product which is called acetal. Now, what is the difference between acetal and hemiacetal? In hemiacetal, there is one OR group. Whereas in acetal, there are two OR groups. This is how an aldehyde reacts with alcohol. And please notice, these reactions are acid catalyzed. Okay? Next. Please copy it down quickly. Next. Okay. So, apart from these, aldehydes and ketones also react with what are called as ammonia derivatives. Tumba important ido. Very, very important. Ammonia and its derivatives. Okay? Because in CET, you get a lot of questions based on this particular idea. Yes. Questions on this reaction is frequently asked. Okay? Now, what happens here? An aldehyde or a ketone is made to react with an ammonia derivative. This is what you call ammonia derivative. Ammonia derivative. Okay. So when hydrogen is replaced by this group Z. Now what happens? How do you figure out the product? The two interact losing a molecule of water, lost, and you get carbon nitrogen double bond. See this? An imine kind of a linkage. This will be the product usually. So you should remember all the Z groups. That is what is the most important thing. All Z groups. So, if Z group is H, the reagent is ammonia and the corresponding product is this and it's called imine. Okay. If the Z group is R, then what you have is amine and the corresponding product is called shift base or a substituted imine. If Z group is OH, then the corresponding reagent is called hydroxylamine. Names and structures, both you should remember. Hydroxylamine. And the corresponding product is called oxime. If the Z group is NH2, then the reagent is called hydrazine. And the corresponding product that you get is hydrazone. If the Z group is this benzene ring attached to NH, you call this reagent phenylhydrazine. And the corresponding product has phenylhydrazone. Now, what are you doing in all these cases? You are just removing H2. With double bond oxygen. Okay? All these in the first column are Z groups. Same way, if you have 2,4-DNP, popularly called 2,4-DNP, 2,4-DNP, dinitrophenylhydrazine, yellow color reagent, it gives you 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. This is the product. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. Now, if the reactant is, or if the reagent is semi-carbazide, okay? If it's semi-carbazide, the product you get is semi-carbazone. You get semi-carbazone as a product. E table na chanda practice maadi. You should practice it, okay? Yenen practice maadbeku idralli? Overall reaction. This is important, okay? And then notice what the Z groups are. And also how to get the product. If you understand the overall reaction, where you remove water molecule to show the product, you can write the products for all these, provided you know the structures and names. Okay? Yes. That's about reactions of aldehydes and ketones with ammonia derivatives. Okay. Let us proceed further. You'll get this in your NCERT textbook. Your NCERT textbook is a tabular column there. So just go through it. Okay? Yes. Next. Okay. Reduction reactions. See, aldehydes and ketones are so placed that they can undergo both oxidation reduction. Aldehydes can be oxidized, aldehydes can be reduced. Now we have reduction reactions of aldehydes. Okay? These are two very, very, very important reactions. One is where, first example, one is where an aldehyde or a ketone is made to react with amalgamated zinc. Amalgamated andre eno, an alloy of zinc and mercury, an alloy of zinc and mercury, this increases the reactivity of zinc. Okay, amalgamating it with mercury increases its reactivity. Now you use this reagent in presence of concentrated HCl, see what happens. Net change in acid absorb body, it's very very clear. C double bond O in there, that is becoming CH2 easy. Okay, so in all these cases C double bond O would become CH2. See, would simply become CH2. That's all. Reduction. After all, what is reduction? Addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen. Here both taking place. Okay. Now this reaction where you use zinc amalgam in presence of concentrated HCl is another very popular name reaction. You call it Clemmensen reduction. Everybody, Clemmensen reduction. And Clemmensen reduction operates under acidic conditions. Operates under acidic conditions. Okay, important. Okay, now look at the next one. Next reaction, example 2, also has the same change taking place. What is it? C double bond O getting replaced by CH2 at the end. But here, first it forms an amine. This is an amine, and amine upon alkaline hydrolysis gives you the corresponding alkane. All these are alkanes, the alkane hydrocarbon. This product is also alkane. Okay, so you get the same result, but this reaction will not be called Clemmensen. It is Wolff-Kishner reduction. Wolff-Kishner reduction, very important. ನೀವ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಂತಿರ್ಬೋದು ಕ್ಲೆಮೆನ್ಸನ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವೋಲ್ಫ್-ಕಿಶ್ನರ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಮತ್ತೆ? ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಕ್ಲೆಮೆನ್ಸನ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೋಲ್ಫ್-ಕಿಶ್ನರ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್? ಕ್ಲೆಮೆನ್ಸನ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್, ವೋಲ್ಫ್-ಕಿಶ್ನರ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಆಲ್ಕಲೈನ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಆಲ್ಕಲೈನ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್. Operates under alkaline conditions. Very important. Yes, good, good. Okay, that's about two very popular reactions: Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction. Important. Please mark it. Mark what point is more important. Frequently asked. Frequently asked in entrance exams. Either Clemmensen or Wolff-Kishner. One of it. Okay, next, aldehydes and ketones can also be oxidized. So let's check out oxidation reactions of aldehydes and ketones. So we discussed reduction reactions, now oxidation reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, an aldehyde is straight away oxidized to carboxylic acid. An aldehyde is always oxidized to carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids. Okay, with same number of carbon atoms, that's important. With same number of carbon atoms as aldehyde, okay. But look at the next one, ketone. Ketones are not that easily oxidized, but if you force it to oxidize, it will give you carboxylic acids with less number of carbon atoms. Super important point though. That's the difference between the oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. If aldehydes oxidize madidre, you will get carboxylic acids with same number of carbon atoms. Check maadi illi one carbon atom ide, here also there is one carbon atom. But check this out, here there are multiple carbon atoms. None of these products will have the same number of carbon atoms. So here carbon atoms or carboxylic acids, carboxylic acids with less number of carbon atoms. Sorry, lesser carbon atoms than alcohol. Important, important. Okay, And one more important point is aldehydes are more in number of carbon atoms. So here carbon atoms or carboxylic acids with less number of carbon atoms. lesser carbon atoms than alcohol. Important. Okay. And one more important point is aldehydes are more easily oxidized than ketones. Is right it? Accordingly, aldehydes are easily oxidized than ketones. Easily oxidized than ketones. Yes. Good. So that's about the oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. Now remember, because aldehydes are easily oxidized, they can be oxidized even by mild oxidizing agents. And one such mild oxidizing agent is Tollens reagent. And the corresponding reaction is called Tollens test. This is Tollens reagent. This is how we represent it. Okay. Ammoniacal silver nitrate is Tollens reagent. Tollens reagent. Now, what happens when an aldehyde is meant to react with Tollens reagent? Aldehyde gets oxidized, but what happens to Tollens reagent? It gets reduced to metallic silver. If this gets deposited on the inner side of the glass test tube or whatever vessel you are carrying out the reaction in, this converts that into a mirror. Hence, it's also called silver mirror test. Silver mirror test. This is a reaction shown exclusively by aldehydes, not by ketones. Okay, so Tollens test is shown by both aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes. Aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes. Aromatic aldehydes. Okay. Whereas, look at the next one, Fehling's test. Fehling's test and Tollens. This also is a mild oxidizing agent. Also converts aldehyde to its corresponding oxidase form. But in turn, see what it gets reduced to. This is Fehling's solution. This is how you can represent Fehling's. Okay. See what is cupric ion getting reduced to? Cupric ion is getting reduced to reddish precipitate of cupric brick red precipitate of cuprous oxide. Okay. Now, what's the specialty of this? This is a test shown only by aliphatic aldehydes, not aromatic aldehydes. Shown only by aliphatic aldehydes. Yes, done. This is Tollens test and Fehling's test. Okay. We will now go to the next slide. I will just pause for a couple of minutes so that we can write down all these points. Points will work out. Next. Oxidation of methyl ketones. This is a type of oxidation for methyl ketones. And this is called haloform reaction. In this method, you have a methyl ketone. What is a methyl ketone? Any ketone with this methyl group, at least one methyl group is a methyl ketone. This is a methyl ketone. Okay. So when a methyl ketone is made to react with a halogen in presence of a base, it forms a corresponding haloform. This is haloform. Hence the name haloform reaction. Okay. And haloform reaction does not affect double bond. Observe what? Reacted to the double bond there, and that double bond is also intact in the product. Product and double bond hage ide, and you know, double bond is not affected in the haloform reaction. Carbon carbon double bond not affected in haloform reaction. Okay. Then, apart from ethyl ketones, what other compounds will undergo haloform reaction? Yes, see this. Check this out, all of you. Haloform reaction is shown by one methyl ketones. Now examples note the methyl ketones, alva. Now apart from methyl ketones alone, innu kelu compounds ide which show haloform reaction. You should be aware of that. Yeah, one acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is the only aldehyde which shows haloform reaction. Okay. And apart from that, you have this compounds called methyl carbenols. Okay, these are the form CH3CHOH. Okay, these also show haloform reaction. Okay, yes, that's about oxidation reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones. The last category of reactions of aldehydes and ketones is on account of presence of acidic alpha hydrogen. In any aldehyde or a ketone, it's the alpha hydrogen. Check this out. This is the functional group. This is the functional group, carbonyl group. And carbon attached to it directly is your alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon. Hence, this becomes your alpha hydrogen. And that alpha hydrogen is acidic. Why is that acidic? Because after removal of this H plus, the anion that is obtained is resonance stabilized. Once again, this is resonance stabilized. Okay, next. Now there are couple of reactions which take place either due to the presence of alpha hydrogen or due to the absence of alpha hydrogen. Okay. Now first, let us take up reactions due to presence of alpha hydrogen. Presence of alpha hydrogen, and one such very popular reaction is called aldol condensation. Aldol condensation. What happens here? An aldehyde with alpha hydrogen. That's the primary condition. Aldehyde with alpha hydrogen in presence of a dilute base, undergoes self addition to give an aldol. This is an aldol. So why is it called an aldol? Because it has both alcohol functional group and aldehyde functional group. Hence it's called aldol. Now this undergoes dehydration, removal of water, to give you an alpha beta unsaturated product. Okay, so that is aldol condensation. So what kind of aldehydes or ketones undergo aldol condensation? Those which have alpha hydrogen. That is aldol condensation. So what kind of aldehydes or ketones undergo aldol condensation? Those which have alpha hydrogen. Okay. Now if you carry out aldol reaction between two different aldehydes, aldol condensation between two different aldehydes or ketones, then you call it cross aldol condensation. In aldol condensation, you take only one type of aldehyde or ketone, whereas in cross aldol condensation, you take two different types of aldehydes or ketones. What's the consequence of this? The consequence of this is you get a mixture of compounds. Mixture of four compounds. Okay, that is the speciality of cross aldol condensation. Okay, so aldol product hey bariyudu anta chennagi abhyasa madbeku. I'll just show you how the aldol product is written. This is how you should always write the aldol product. Let me take the example of acetaldehyde. See, CH3, okay, CH. In place of double bond O, make it single bond OH, because this molecule is attacked by nucleophile. Becomes OH. What is getting attacked? Or what attacks it? the other aldehyde molecule which has lost its alpha proton, which has lost its alpha hydrogen. So let me write the next aldehyde molecule with its alpha carbon. This will be its alpha carbon. What will be its, what will be attached to? CH2. Okay, and then CHO. This is alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon. Okay, it would have lost alpha hydrogen, and this is the new bond. This is a new bond formed between the two. This is what is aldol. Hence, aldol condensation. Okay, next, last reaction. Last reaction. Couple of minutes, write it down. Couple of seconds, I'll wait. Write it down. Okay. ఇక కొనే రియాక్షన్ పోవడం లాస్ట్ రియాక్షన్ ఈజ్ దిస్ రియాక్షన్ కాల్డ్ క్యానిజరో రియాక్షన్ క్యానిజరో రియాక్షన్ అనదర్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ రియాక్షన్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ డ్యూ టు ద అబ్సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా హైడ్రోజన్ డ్యూ టు అబ్సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా హైడ్రోజన్ నెనపెట్టుకోండి ఆల్ఫా హైడ్రోజన్ ఇద్దరే ఆల్డోల్ కండెన్సేషన్ ఇఫ్ ఆల్ఫా హైడ్రోజన్ ఇస్ అబ్సెంట్ దెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ Cannizzaro reaction. What happens in Cannizzaro reaction? Please check it. One molecule of aldehyde gets oxidized. One molecule of aldehyde gets oxidized. What is the oxidized product of aldehyde? Carboxylic acids. But because condition is alkaline, you get its corresponding carboxylate. One aldehyde is oxidized to carboxylate. Because under alkaline conditions, if conditions are alkaline, the carboxylic acid formed will react with the alkali to form its corresponding salt. Okay, this is the oxidized product. Carboxylate is the oxidized product. Oxidized. Okay, now apart from that, you also end up getting an alcohol, a primary alcohol. Primary alcohol always. Obviously, right? When do you get the primary alcohol from an aldehyde? When it undergoes reduction. This is product of reduction. Reduction. Yes. So what do you call such reactions where a single compound undergoes both oxidation and reduction? It is called a disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation reaction. So aldehydes without alpha hydrogen undergo this disproportionation. Okay. Right. This is really the last reaction. We'll end it. End it here. So typical reaction of aromatic aldehydes, electrophilic substitution. This reaction is shown by aromatic aldehydes. What type of group is aldehyde group? Check this. Aldehyde group is minus R group. It shows minus R effect. It is deactivating the ring. Ring deactivating. And it also directs the incoming electrophile to the meta position, meta directing it is. Meta directing, yes. These are all about chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones, okay. We will end the session here. For next session, we will check out the questions on chemical properties. Chemical properties, mineral questions, no, okay? Yes. Thank you, all of you.